Today I will be comparing Trustend and Genie DSLR cages. Hi everyone, I've been meaning to do a comparison video between my Trustend and my Genie DSLR cages for quite a while now, and it's time to get into it today. First off, some information about each cage. I first got this Trustend cage more than a year ago, and I've used it a lot with my Canon 5D Mark II because this particular cage is designed for Canon DSLRs like 5D, 7D, 60D, and some latest Canon DSLRs too. The Genie cage, I got this maybe about half a year ago. When it first came out, I got it on a special deal for around 100 bucks. So I couldn't resist getting this. And I got this to use with my secondary cameras. For example, this Sony NAX5N. It works with this particular camera really well, making it much more stable setup. So let me first show you the features on this thing. As I said before, it's been designed with the Canon DSLR in mind. And let me show you why. We've got an opening here on the side for the memory card compartment. So very easily accessible. You can get your cards in and take them out very easily. We've got opening on the bottom for the battery compartment. Again, very easily accessible. Right there, we can take out the battery and put a new one without having to take the camera out of the cage. We also have some openings on the top here, as you can see, for the screen, so you can easily read the information from the top, and the mode dial, so you can see what mode are you in from the top. We also have lots of threaded holes on the top for all sorts of accessory connections that you might wanna connect up to this cage. There's some more threaded holes on the sides. And let's see, and we have some more on the bottom of the cage as well. That's pretty cool. Then also one really cool feature with this cage is this very compact adapter for your 15mm rods. You put them in there. I'll show you that setup in a minute. But the best feature of the cage is the HDMI clamp that it has on the side. Again, this is specifically designed for Canon DSLRs in mind. And this is quite a unique feature that I haven't seen on other cages. So let me quickly show you how this works. Let's imagine this is my HDMI cable. This is just adapter, but it will do for this test. I'll put it in there. Then I tighten the cable, the clamp right there, and it's not going anywhere. I can even hold it like so, and you can see it's not gonna go anywhere. This is fixed in place as if it's always been there. As we know, HDMI connection is not a very secure connection. It's not very well suitable for professional shooting. It's very easy to just catch the cable by accident and it will pop out very easily. It's not the problem with Canons. It's a problem with any camera that has HDMI connection. And this particular clamp solves that problem. You're not gonna have your monitor switching off and your recording stopping on your camera because the cable pops out during the take by accident. Let me show you the features of this cage. This is a quite nicely customizable cage. I currently have the top plate lowered so it accommodates the Sony 5N, and it also means that the camera is protected better. So that's how I have it at the moment, but the top plate can be positioned higher if you need, and it can even be taken off. The rods can also be shortened by half. These particular rods can be unscrewed in the middle, and you can just have a shorter set of rods with a smaller camera like 5N. Same as with the Trusim cage, there are some cutouts on the top and the bottom. They are exactly the same. And this works quite nicely with the battery compartment with Sony 5N. We can get that battery out easily, again, without taking off the camera. I think this will also work well with the Canon 5D and probably with quite a lot of other DSLRs. We also have lots of threaded holes on this cage, same as with the Trusim cage, although these are just two sizes. And there's also a larger size, or even two different larger size on Trusim, so it's quite a bit more flexible in that sense. As you can see, this cage also has handles. This is a very cool feature and something that I quite miss in a Trusim cage. I can basically operate the camera with just my cage in my hands. It is much more stable than just holding the camera. It's a bit like a fig rig. If you guys used to use something like this with your camcorder or something like that, this will be familiar feeling to you. This is much, much more stable than holding a small or even a Canon DSLR with your hands. You can sort of do that with this cage, but it's nowhere as comfortable as holding this cage with your both hands for nice steady shots. The knobs on each cage are very similar and simple, as you can see, but they work well. I didn't have any problems with the threads or anything like that. The Trusim cage also has ratchet knobs on the bottom because there's limited space on the bottom. And I really like this particular knobs. I wish all accessories had this kind of knobs and not just these simple ones that can't be moved out of the way, because it is sometimes annoying when you tighten something down and these things just stick out in all sorts of positions and it's not very tidy and sometimes can be in a way. So as you can see, both of these cages have their own advantages, but the main question for me is which cage worth its money more. As I said before, Trusim cage costs a bit more than the Genie. It's about $100 more or something like that. And is it really worth this extra money? If you're using a Canon DSLR like 5D, 7D or 60D, Trusim is definitely a better option for you. As I said, it's been designed for these cameras and there's virtually no better option on the market for that kind of DSLR. It will work with other DSLRs, but some of the features on this cage will not make much sense with other DSLRs, and that's where something like a Genie cage comes into the picture. It's cheaper, it's still really solid, it's highly customizable. You can mount lots of accessories on the top here and even some on this 15mm rods. You have handles with this. It's great for simple handheld operation where it's just the cage and the camera. It's nice and smooth. It's much smoother than just holding a camera, as I said before. So it's great for that. But then if you want to add some follow focus matte box or shoulder rig to this setup, it gets a little complicated and it will cost you more money. You will need something like this to go on the bottom of the cage, mount it on there, and you will basically have something like that. But then, as you can see, it becomes quite a big, heavy setup, and things like this will cost you money as well. So it's something to think about when buying a cage. You need to think about what you're gonna do with it in future and how much more money you will need to spend on extra accessories if you need them. By the time you get rods and the clamp, it might cost the same as the Trusim cage. The Trusim cage, as I said, on the other hand, already comes with a very compact clamp for your rods. So you only need a set of rods that go there. Tighten this up with this really nice ratchet knobs. And here you go, we are ready to go and put a full focus in there. You can put a matte box in there. You don't need to buy a separate adapter or clamp for your cage just to mount a full focus, something like that, on this cage. So if you've been looking to buy any of these cages, hopefully this video clarifies some things for you. Thanks for watching it, and I'll see you in the next one.